Hello, everyone. Today it's January the 5th, my third day of my continuation of my 90 to 120 day juicing. I say that because the intention was to do a for sure straight 60 to 120 days, but I guess I kidded myself. As the holidays came around, I had a few bites of things I shouldn't have had. Baked potato, sweet potato, a couple of cookies. But I mean really only a couple. But it was enough to where you could say the detoxing and the juice journey had ended, if you will. But I refuse to end it totally because I'm not through with what I'm out to accomplish. So I feel really good. Today is my third day of my juicing. I made a really interesting funky juice today. I'll show it to you in a minute, but I actually just had a clean out. I went to the Whole Foods in Seattle a few days ago. So I made a little cheat sheet note because I put a ton of weird things in this juice and I want to share. And this made a full 32 ounces, but it was a little bit of this, a little bit of that. So it wasn't like, you'll see, it was crazy, crazy drink. And I will tell you, when I tell you these ingredients, you'd think it's going to be spicy when you're listening to what I'm going to tell you, but it's actually like a mild spicy. It's very good, okay? So here's what I did, because again, I had a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Okay, 2 handfuls of spinach, red leaf lettuce, half of a head because my husband used it last night for a salad. 1 big beet, broccoli stalk, 5 celery stalks, 1 cucumber, chunk of ginger, a sunchoke about this big around. If anybody knows what a sunchoke is, it's like a Jerusalem. I believe this other name of it is a Jerusalem artichoke. They sell them at Whole Foods. So if anything, you'd go to Whole Foods for it. And 5 radishes. So yep, spice is coming. About a half of a bunch of cilantro. And a garlic clove. And a very tiny, and I mean tiny, this big, orange pepper. Or a half of a regular size orange pepper. And then what I did is I put it in my mason jar. And I'll show you. I put it in my, you've seen this glass before that I make. I put a little bit of sea salt in the bottom of this actual container that I'm going to be drinking. And a little bit of organic flaxseed oil. Or flax oil. It's not flaxseed oil, but let me taste a sip. Oh, I forgot one more ingredient. I just realized it. 1/4 of a red cabbage. I forgot to write that on my little notes here. That's why it's so red, even though it has lots of greens in it. It's very spicy, but if you want something different opposed to sweet and fruity, I also made another drink today that I'll drink later, and that consisted of lemon, ginger, spinach, and cucumber, 1 good-sized red Fuji apple, and a pretty good size, can't remember what kind of pear it was. It was a good-sized pear. All organic. I do all organic. I have for quite some time. Probably the only time I won't do organic is if I want sprouts this time of year. We have a place that's not far away that makes sprouts, but I don't believe they're organics. And I don't put a lot of sprouts in my drinks. However, I'm going to incorporate as many greens as I can, whether I sprout them or not. I don't personally like to sprout this time of year where I live because it's totally, I don't have a grow light. It's too damp. It just doesn't work for me. So that's my opinion. I also like to grow wheatgrass, but I don't do it this time of the year. I purchase some. So anyway, that being said, I'm on a roll again. I never stop being good. Just because I had a few bites of things, I'm not going to kill myself over it. I'm not happy with myself. I tried my best to fight it. But on the other hand, I feel really good. I feel really, really good. And I'm back at the gym, as I said before, and I'm going to continue going. I will say last night I had a very hard time. I actually went to bed early. And again, just because it was my second day last night, you have to understand, I have gone through detox already. I mean deep detox in the sense, not deep detox, let me say that again. The typical beginner detox, which is your headaches or your nausea or your diarrhea or your constipation or all those sort of things, I don't get that. I was grumpy. I, for some reason, wanted chips. And I don't mean chips. I wanted frickin' salsa and chips so bad. And I told my husband, this time around, because his holidays are over, don't give in with me. Like in other words, I'd always go for him and go, oh, just a little bit. Yeah, can I? Oh, can't do that. Just gotta fight it. And it's a frickin' battle, but I'm gonna do it. And I'm gonna continue to do it. And there's so many juicers out there. And this is not just a little whim, because I know some of you have never juiced before and it's the beginning of January. You know, it's one of those, I'm going to do it because I feel like it. Talking about others now. For me, no, this is a lifestyle. It's going to be a lifestyle. It's really interesting, too. You know, this time of year you watch, like, the Dr. Oz show. Speaking of Dr. Oz, yesterday he had Dr. Mercola on again this year, Dr. Joe Mercola on, and it was not a repeat of 2011. So if you want to go to the Google of the Dr. Oz show, when you do that, you have to do doctor, the word doctor, D-O-C-T-O-R, oz.com. Click on yesterday's show, and it will take you to a link about what Dr. Mercola said. Basically, it talked about how important vitamin D is, which I certainly know that. I am taking myself 10,000 IUs Monday through Friday doctor recommendation, because I am, whatever's considered low, and I don't have my information in front of me, but whatever's considered low, like I think the number 13 or 15 is considered low, or 20, whatever it is, I'm like seven numbers under that or something. I'm crazy low. So only Monday through Friday I take either two 5,000 IUs of vitamin D, or 10,000, depending on what my store carries. Right now I'm taking two 5,000, which equals the 10, of course. And what else did he talk about? Saying, he kind of likes the idea of tanning beds, but not the best. Anyway, you go over and look at it if you're interested. Myself, oh, there goes my washing machine in the other room. Hopefully you're not going to hear it. I'll have to go get it in a little bit. Buzz in and let me know it's finished. But what I want to say is I feel good. I have to fight the fight just to go right now. It's in me. I've got it. But I think that's why yesterday I fought it. I went to bed about 10:30, which is not like me. Normally I go to bed at midnight. And it's mostly because I had a want and a need for chomping on chips. And I said no. I never get a headache, but I get a light, how do I explain? Something in my head, I can't explain it, back in the back half is like something's working. I'm sure it's the juices I'm drinking. I don't know. I can't explain it, guys. It's not a headache because I've gone through the deeper detox that way. I just can't explain it. For me, I have to take the one day at a time. I have I'll show you right here. Check it out. Look. January 5th, reboot, day 3. I want to show you something. Don't think I haven't been doing a journal. Look at this. Jody, stop. Let me go right here. Jody, it's okay. Okay. There we go. Started October 30th, Saturday, 2011. Anyway, this is my journal that I've been keeping. There's my TV control. Get that out of there. And this is my new book I bought. Check it out. This is a Hello Kitty book. You're probably saying, what is that? What I'm doing this go around is I'm actually going to write down what I, in like here, juice one and juice two. I usually make enough to carry me through the day. So there's my first day on January 3rd. I restarted this second go. And then there's day two. I made some of the David Renishek tea. And day four is in here as of Tuesday and what my drinks were. Anyway, that's how I continue. That's what I'm doing differently this go around. That's what I'm doing differently. I'm going to kind of make a little booklet of what juices I'm actually juicing, because sometimes I, like today, I just whipped that one together and it was interesting, and I would do it again. Definitely gonna have to brush your teeth after. I do anyway, but every time I put garlic in my body, wow, I really feel the difference. Oh, another thing I want to talk about. I want to talk about how I do my day. This is not my first go around at juicing. This is about my third time around of juicing, and what I've incorporated this time is every other day I do enemas. I've said that before. It cleans you out, you feel good, and things come out, people. Well, let me tell you. Last time, day 22, I think it was, I'm not going to go say just stuff that you've never seen before, okay? Okay? Number two, if I do enemas, I do them in the morning, not right when I wake up, but right after I clean, pick up whatever, take care of dogs, laundry, blah, blah, blah. I do it before noon, let's put it that way. On those days, I usually always wake up to water with lemon juice. And my new thing that I'm doing is taking a half a teaspoon to a teaspoon. I'm working my way up to MSM powder. And we'll get into that one other day, what it is. I'll tell you one thing it's good for. When you're juicing, it's wonderful to help your nails stay strong and your hair to be strong. But my nails, when I juice sometimes, seem to get brittle. They don't get strong. I don't know why. They go the opposite. So when I incorporate MSM, it keeps them strong for me. I also have upped my chlorella tablets, which is, I take 10 in the morning with my water and 10 at night with the same lemon water, probably about 2 hours before bed. I love chlorella. What is chlorella? It's chlorophyll, but so it's the greens that you need for your body. I'm saying a lot of ums today because I'm thinking as I go. I wing this. I don't do a little page of what I'm going to say. That's not me. So, okay, I think I've talked enough today. I want everybody to know out there, I thank everyone for watching. I like the things you say, and I am glad that I'm helping others out there accomplish what they want to do. And rock on to all you out there that are juicing, because it's definitely a journey and it's a day-to-day battle. Especially for you newbies out there that have never juiced before. You know, a lot of people say, oh, I'll just do it for a week. Like I've said in past videos, a week is just not enough. It's just not. I would do a minimum of 21 days. Minimum. See how you feel. If you think you can't live on liquids, you're wrong. Because put those same things in a bowl and think you're going to make a humongous salad out of it and drink it or eat it. Great. Not me. I enjoy the juicing, and it's so uplifting. It's so strong, and I feel the difference. There I go with again, but I'm not going to take these out. Okay, everyone, have a good day, and I'll see you tomorrow or the day after, because I don't make videos every day, or in another 3 days. I don't make them all the time, but I talk when I have something to tell y'all, okay? Bye. Thanks for watching.